Hello, internet friends, YouTube people. Alright, today we're gonna talk about Ben 10, such an amazing cartoon from way back when. And we're gonna talk about all the comic book references that Ben 10 makes. And, well, it's kinda obvious, I don't need to point these ones out, but, well, first you got the flaming head, what's his name? Heat Blast is what Ben 10 calls the alien known as, so he calls him Heat Blast, and there's a separate alien race for this guy. The watch itself is very reminiscent of Green Lantern, and Heat Blast is Human Torch. Then you got several other characters that are references to Heat Blast. Oh, you got the Fast One. You got several speedsters in the comic books. I guess Accelerate is closer to Quicksilver than he is to Flash. And then you got the Upgrade is probably very similar to... In the New Mutants comic book, which is like the Teen Titans of the X-Men, oh, the X-Men themselves are kind of similar to the Teen Titans. So anyways, Animus. I don't know about you guys, but my first comic book, my first episode was... Alright, so I'm going to close the screen up. I'm going to do this quite a bit. Yeah, so fun fact is, you probably don't know this, but the Scavenger from Superboy, the first thing I thought about when I saw Animus, like I said, that episode was my first. Animus was my first Ben 10 villain. So here's some panels from that relevant comic book. This is the Scavenger, and he is like the second enemy that Superboy makes. just like Animus, Scavenger appears in like the previous issue, and they're both after some artifact. And the spear of Lono, a Hawaiian thing, that's basically what Animus was after. Just a wild guess, but it wouldn't do any good to say I had no idea what you're talking about, right? So it's like Superboy doesn't even remember this guy. And he's always behind some artifact. Like, you know, artifacts in comic book stories, they're kind of like MacGuffins. That's what these guys are all fighting about. Like, the MacGuffin is basically this stupid thing that you're holding in your hand, and that's what the good guy and the bad guy are both fighting for. And so, yeah. Once again, I'm going to close the screen because I don't want to give away the resources I am using for this. We're gonna go to the Omnitrix and just talk about the kinds of aliens that they have. Forearms, obviously, is the equivalent of the Thing, right? Or the Hulk. You got heavy hitters. So basically, all comic book characters can be divided into... All superheroes in comic books can be divided into... A range of... So this is the Omnitrix. I couldn't find the original 10 aliens, but so yeah, before Vilgax, before anyone, there's just so many references to comic books, and I like that.